Injection molding machine is a highly sophisticated machine, but it can be divided into three main sections or unit: injection unit, mold, and clamping unit. Each unit, like injection unit, made of several parts. Like injection unit consists of motors, hopper, screw, heating element, valve, and other. Each of this unit performs a specific task during injection molding cycle. The task of injection unit is melting the polymer and then injecting into the mold cavity. Similarly, the mold performs two main tasks. First one, it provides shape to the product, and also it helps to cool the molten polymer into a solid product. Similarly, clamping unit is responsible for two main tasks. One is called mold mobility. Through this, molds open and closes. And second function is, it helps to release the product from the mold. This is a very important function, because in absence of automatic product release, continuous operation of injection molding is not possible. So let's now discuss about the injection molding process. This video is an excellent representation of injection molding process. Here we can see that polymer beads are fed through this hopper and products are coming out of the mold. Now if we look little bit in more detail how the polymer beads are converted into plastic parts, we can see that polymers are first fed through this hopper, which gets melted inside the extruder. The molten polymer is accumulated in front of the extruder. During this time, we can also see that the extruder moves in the backward direction. This mechanism is very similar to the syringe. While operating syringe, we have seen that the plunger is moved in the back direction to fill the syringe with the medicine or any other liquid. Then this plunger is pushed forward to inject medicine in our body. Similarly, in case of injection molding, the screw moves in forward direction to inject polymer melt in the mold cavity. Now, to better understand the injection molding process, we can divide the whole injection molding process in four steps. It will also help us to better understand the injection molding parameters in each step, which controls the whole process and also quality of the product. First step is melting. In this step, polymers which are fed through the hopper gets melted inside the extruder and stored in front of the screw. The parameter which is very important at this step is melt temperature. Usually, extruders are kept at 40 to 50 degrees C higher than the melting temperature of polymer. But the temperature can be lower or higher depending upon the additive present in the polymer. If a polymer contains lubricant, the temperature should be lower. Otherwise, the melt viscosity will be too low. Similarly, if the polymer contains nanofillers or reinforcing filler, then the temperature should be higher so that the polymer can have sufficient viscosity. Second step is injection. In this step, the screw moves forward and injects polymer inside the mold cavity. Now the question is, how much polymer need to be injected, and second is, how fast we need to inject the polymer. So the two parameters which is very important in this step is shot size, which is also called injection volume, and the injection speed. Now let's discuss these two parameters in a little bit more detail. When polymer gets injected in the mold, the polymer need to fill the whole mold cavity, like sprue volume, runner volume, and also the product volume. Melts when undergoes cooling, it also leads to shrinkage. So when calculating shot size, we also need to take polymer shrinkage in the calculation. Now two conditions may arise. The shot size may be smaller than the mold cavity, which is called shot size. This will lead to underfill. Second condition is, when the shot size is higher than the mold cavity, in this case flash will occur. Here the pictorial demonstration of the flash. Ideal volume, so the ideal injection volume will be mold cavity plus shrinkage. The next question is, how fast we would like to fill the mold cavity. It is always desired to fill the mold as fast as possible, because it leads to higher efficiency of the injection molding process. But at very high injection speed, it leads to jetting, which deteriorates the product quality. So the injection speed will be an optimum value between efficiency and the product quality. Third step in the injection molding process is called packing and cooling. In this step, polymer melt is compressed to get better product uniformity. At the same time, polymer melt is cooled to a solid product. Two parameters which are very important in this step are injection pressure and cooling time. Higher injection pressure leads to better packing and better uniformity of the product. But injection pressure need to be balanced by the clamping pressure. Clamping pressure is the pressure between the two mold sections. If injection pressure is much higher than the clamping pressure, it will lead to flashing. Therefore, injection pressure is decided based on the maximum clamping pressure of the injection molding machine. Similarly, cooling time is an optimized value between injection molding efficiency and product quality. Typically, a higher mold temperature leads to product with better strength and gloss. But higher mold temperature requires longer cooling time. So, depending upon the product quality requirement, cooling time is decided. But usually, it ranges from 5 seconds to 20 seconds. The fourth step is ejection. In this step, the moving section of the mold moves backward and opens the mold. During this time, the ejector pin pushes the product out of the mold. The product is then collected at the bottom of the machine. In this step, the important parameter is ejector pin speed. A lower speed will be unable to remove the product from the mold, but a higher pin speed will leave a pin mark on the product. So, the ejector pin speed is optimized to achieve desired performance and product quality. So, during injection molding process, polymer beads are converted into plastic parts in 4 steps: melting, injection, cooling and ejection. The key parameters during injection molding processes are mold temperature, shot size, injection speed, mold temperature, injection pressure and cooling time. These parameters are highly optimized to achieve continuous production of parts. Now let's discuss some of the advantages and disadvantages of injection molding. Injection molding is one of the most versatile and efficient product manufacturing process. However, it also suffers from some limitations. Some of the advantages and disadvantages of injection molding are listed here. One of the major advantages of injection molding is fast production. Once injection molding parameters are optimized, product manufacturing time is only few seconds. Another very important benefit of injection molding is low labor cost, since most of the industrial processes are automated. Injection molding also offers design flexibility and use of multiple materials. Advantages of injection molding are: it can be used to produce very small parts, it leaves little scrap and reduces requirement of finishing. Because of its automated operation, product quality is very consistent. Now let's talk about some of the disadvantages of injection molding.